we did with our haying in the summer. We would have to help with the haying. Us girls would always love to, and our little brothers, we'd ride on the hay wagon coming back to the barn. And the older brothers, of course, are still picking up, you know, hay with the forks and throwing it up on the haystack. And, of course, many times they would throw a snake up, and us girls would just be screaming and carrying on and sliding down the other side of the wagon. No, we had a lot of fun that way, and we made our own fun, actually, you know. And of course, in the winter, we had the sleigh riding down the cemetery hill, and you could watch our brothers or whoever it was, if you weren't up there from the kitchen window, you could see them coming down right from the top of the old Agassiz Mountain or the cemetery, and we'd be weaving down through around the tombstones, and then we'd end up just flying right through our neighbors, who was the Hawklocks across the road. We'd just fly right under their fence and into their field. So, it was great. It was great. All the neighbor kids, they would come and catch the school bus at our milk stand. And that was, I guess, because we had the most, you know, the more kids, I don't know. But that was great. And, many times, like I said, I'd be out milking cows in I still had my pajamas on, and the neighbor boy happened to one morning poke his head in, Clifford Anderson, and when I finally got to school, my teacher right away had said, "Oh, Pat, hi. Nice to see you. I understand that you milk cows in your pajamas." And, oh my God, I was so embarrassed. I just didn't. But anyways, that's the way it was. And actually, we also did that because it was so gold darn cold. It might have been almost, you know, in the winter. So we kept all the clothes on we could. But, no, we, in that house, there was a bedroom for Mom and Dad, a bedroom for the girls, and a bedroom for the boys. So we, at first, before Dad eventually added on, we slept six in a bed, and three down, three up one end, three in the other, and my sister Faye, the oldest of the girls, she was kind of, well, I guess you'd say she was bossy at the time, but she didn't have much choice because she had quite a role to play with, you know, in our family with trying to help raise the kids. So she would say, "Now, you put your feet there. You lie there and don't move." Well, if we moved and we got giggling or something, Faye would push us out of bed. And many times we'd end up sleeping on the floor. She'd throw us a blanket, maybe, and maybe not. And then sometimes we'd just beg her, "Faye, please, could you let us back in?" And she'd let us back in sometimes.